Hey guys, it's Shane again. Listen, I'm back at the World of Macintosh here in New York. And this week I want to talk about Starbucks. You know, we've been all talking about them. They're in the media, they're everywhere right now. Listen, on April 12th, obviously we had an incident. And for the first time in a while, I think Starbucks values got challenged. Starbucks talks about creating a culture of warmth and belonging where everyone's welcome. They talk about treating people with respect and transparency. And listen, what happened on April 12th is they failed. But really, is it a cultural failure? That's the question that we won't know for some time, but the way that Starbucks is responding, where on May 29th they're going to shut down 8,000 stores and put them through some sort of training, that's a pretty powerful statement. That's a company that really believes and knows that its values are more important than anything else. But here's the caveat. I've done a lot of training programs. One day of training doesn't change mindsets and attitudes. It doesn't change how people feel. This is a much greater problem, one that I don't think Starbucks has, but for any other company out there, thinking that putting someone through a diversity training for a day is going to solve any problems with regards to how you treat and respect other people, you're mistaken. Listen, if anybody can do it, it's Starbucks. I'm cheering for you. I'm going to be disappointed on May 29th when I don't get my Starbucks coffee, but I'll be really excited on the 30th when I get back in there, knowing that you took a stand and that your values are so damn important to you that you're willing to sacrifice revenues and the ability of possibly having some of your customers go somewhere else to make sure that your culture remains intact. For every other company out there, you got to do a lot more than that, so I'm cheering for you, Starbucks. Good luck.